Chapter 10, Cell Cycle and Cell Division, Short Notes and Summary from Class 11th, Subject Biology. Introduction. All multicellular organisms originate from a single cell. Through repeated cycles of growth and division, one parental cell gives rise to two daughter cells, which themselves can grow and divide, ultimately forming tissues and organs composed of millions of cells. 10.1 Cell Cycle. The cell cycle is the ordered sequence of events by which a cell duplicates its genome, synthesizes new cellular components, and divides into two daughter cells. DNA replication and cell growth are coordinated to ensure accurate transmission of genetic material. 10.1.1 Phases of Cell Cycle. Eukaryotic cells generally spend most of their time in interphase and a brief period in M phase. Interphase, G1, Gap 1, metabolic activity and cell growth, no DNA replication, S synthesis, DNA duplication, DNA content doubles, 2C to 4C, but chromosome number remains constant, 2N. G2, Gap 2, further growth and synthesis of proteins required for mitosis. M phase, mitosis plus cytokinesis, nuclear division, karyokinesis, followed by cytoplasmic division, cytokinesis. In human cells, this phase lasts about 1 hour of an average 24-hour cycle. Interphase covers the remaining 95%. 10.2 M phase. M phase is the period during which a cell undergoes mitosis, equational division, to produce two genetically identical daughter nuclei, followed by cytokinesis. Although mitosis is traditionally divided into four stages, these transitions are progressive rather than sharply demarcated. 10.2.1 Prophase. Key events marking prophase. Chromatin condenses into visible paired sister chromatids attached at centromeres. Centrosomes, duplicated during S phase, move toward opposite poles, nucleating esters and spindle fibers. Disappearance of nuclear envelope, nucleolus, Golgi complex and ER, late prophase. 10.2.2 Metaphase. Metaphase is characterized by complete breakdown of the nuclear envelope, maximum chromosome condensation, each chromosome composed of two sister chromatids, spindle fibers attached to kinetochores on centromeres, alignment of chromosomes along the metaphase plate at the cell equator. 10.2.3 Anaphase. During anaphase, centromeres split, freeing sister chromatids, now daughter chromosomes. Spindle fibers shorten, pulling chromatids toward opposite poles with centromeres leading the way. 10.2.4 Telophase. Telophase involves arrival of chromatids at poles and decondensation of chromatin, reformation of nuclear envelopes around each set of chromosomes, reappearance of nucleoli, Golgi complexes and ER. 10.2.5 Cytokinesis. Cytokinesis physically divides the cytoplasm. Animal cells, cleavage furrow constricts plasma membrane until two cells form. Plant cells, vesicles coalesce at the cell center to form a cell plate that grows outward to meet existing walls, establishing the middle lamella. 10.3 Significance of mitosis ensures growth of multicellular organisms by increasing cell number, maintains nucleocytoplasmic ratio for proper cell function, facilitates tissue repair and replacement, example skin, gut lining, blood cells, supports continual growth in plant meristems, apical and lateral cambium. 10.4 Meiosis. Meiosis is a specialized form of cell division in diploid cells that produces four haploid daughter cells, gametes. It consists of one round of DNA replication followed by two sequential divisions, meiosis 1 and 2, and includes pairing and recombination of homologous chromosomes. 10.4.1 Meiosis 1 Prophase 1, 5 substages. Leptotin, chromosomes condense and become visible. Zygotene, homologous chromosome synapse forming bivalents via synaptonemal complexes. Pachytene, tetrads form, crossing over at recombination nodules, exchanges genetic material. Diplotene, synaptonemal complex dissolves, homologs remain joined at chiasmata. Diakinesis, chiasmata terminalize, chromosomes fully condense, nuclear envelope breaks down. So friends, I have provided the figure for 5 sub-stages. Metaphase 1, bivalent align at the metaphase plate with spindle fibers attached to kinetochores of homologs. Anaphase 1, homologous chromosomes separate to opposite poles, sister chromatid remain joined. Telophase 1 plus interkinesis, cytokinesis yields two haploid dyads, interkinesis occurs without DNA replication. 10.4.2 Meiosis 2 resembles mitosis but starts with haploid cells. Prophase 2, chromosomes condense, nuclear envelope breaks down. Metaphase 2, chromosomes align singly at the metaphase plate. Anaphase 2, centromeres split, sister chromatids move to opposite poles. Telophase 2 plus cytokinesis, nuclear envelopes reform. Cytokinesis produces 4 genetically distinct haploid cells. 10.5 Significance of meiosis, halves chromosome number to maintain species chromosome count across generations, generates genetic diversity through recombination and independent assortment, drives evolutionary adaptability by creating new allele combinations. Summary: the cell cycle orchestrates genome replication, growth, and division in a tightly regulated sequence. Mitosis produces two identical diploid cells, essential for growth, repair, and asexual reproduction. Meiosis, involving two consecutive divisions after one DNA replication, reduces chromosome number by half and introduces variation, forming 4 haploid gametes, vital for sexual reproduction and evolutionary adaptability. Cytokinesis completes these divisions by physically partitioning cytoplasm with distinct mechanisms in plant and animal cells. Together, mitosis and meiosis underpin organismal development, reproduction, and genetic continuity. So friends, we have completed short notes and summary of chapter 10, cell cycle and cell division. We will do question answers of this chapter in a separate video. If you like the video, kindly like it and share it with your friends. Also subscribe to my channel. We will meet in the next video. Thank you for watching.